Let's say you think about your app as a series of widgets. Let's say you have a widget here that has some internal components. That what could the widget do? Let's say this one is a dropdown. Then you have another widget here that takes care of, let's say, the user profile. So it has a face and some names and things like that. So you have components in here, and you have components in here as well, which means that you should have a global data store that takes care of data that is shared by both of these components. So both widgets have some data that needs to be in common. Let's say whether the user is logged in or whether a super massive error has happened that the entire application needs to stop. And this works well. You then have actions here. They both feed into actions and they go back to the store. Your data flows in a single direction and everyone's happy. But what about inside? Should this store know about the internal state of a widget for dropdowns? So the internal state of a dropdown widget would be how many items are there, which items are we displaying, is the widget open or not, is there a search term. What you should be doing is that you have another small store here. This could be either local state or something that you put in context, maybe even a completely separate redux state or mobx store or whatever. And inside here, your data goes in a single direction. It doesn't, data that this widget requires or this group of components needs and other components on the page don't care about should be local to this section here. When you think about it, the way your app should be structured is as a series of stores which have some sort of hierarchy, and within those stores you then have unidirectional data flows, or rather between those stores you have unidirectional data flows that all go back to the main store, and you kind of connect things that way. So the idea is you have many local sources of truth that handle a single area of your application, and then you have a global one that facilitates communication between different parts of your app. That's kind of the approach we're going to be using from here on out when we build our example app through four different technologies for data management. State management,